Welcome to an example on how to find the partial fraction decomposition of a rational expression. Partial fraction decomposition is a method used to write a given rational expression as a sum or difference of simpler rational expressions, which is often helpful when integrating in calculus. Before we perform partial fraction decomposition, we need to make sure the degree of the numerator is less than the degree of the denominator. In this case, our numerator is degree 1, denominator is degree 2, so this is in the correct form. If the degree of the numerator is equal to or greater than the degree of the denominator, we would start by performing long division. So for the first step, we're going to factor the denominator completely. So we'll have the quantity x plus 5 divided by this trinomial factors into two binomials. The factors of x squared are x and x. The factors of positive 3 that add to positive 4 are positive 3 and positive 1. Now that we have this in factored form, the factors of our denominator determine how we're going to set up the fractions to perform partial fraction decomposition. In this case, we have two distinct or two different linear factors, which means we'll have two fractions on the right, where one fraction has a denominator of x plus 3, and another fraction has a denominator of x plus 1. Now, if we had repeating linear factors or quadratic factors, this would affect how we set up the fractions here on the right side. And we'll see examples of this in the next few videos. And again, because we have linear factors in the denominator, our numerator is going to be a constant, which we don't know the value of right now, so we'll use the variable a here and the variable b here. If we had three distinct linear factors, the next numerator would be c. We never use the same variable twice in the numerator. So our goal here is to find the value of a and b so that if we add these two fractions, the sum would be equal to the original rational expression. So for the next step, we're going to clear the fractions by multiplying both sides of the equation by the LCD, or least common denominator, which would be the quantity x plus 3 times the quantity x plus 1. Notice on the left side we have x plus 3 over x plus 3, that simplifies to 1, and so does x plus 1 over x plus 1. So this simplifies nicely to x plus 5. On the right side, notice this first product, we would have an x plus 3 over x plus 3 that simplifies to 1, leaving us with a times the quantity x plus 1. And then for the second product, we have an x plus 1 over x plus 1. That simplifies to 1, leaving us with plus b times the quantity x plus 3. This equation here is called the basic equation, and we're going to use this to find the values of a and b. And there are two methods for doing this. One method is called equating coefficients, where we multiply out the right side of this equation, combine like terms, and then set the coefficients of the like terms equal to each other from the left side of the equation and the right side of the equation, which gives us a system of equations which we can then solve. But a shortcut method which we'll use in this video is to select convenient values of x in order to find the values of a and b. The convenient values will be the values of x that make x plus 1 equal to 0 and x plus 3 equal to 0. So let's first let x equal negative 1. So we'll substitute negative 1 into the equation, which will help us find the value of b. So if x equals negative 1, notice how on the left side we'd have negative 1 plus 5, that's 4, equals, if x equals negative 1, we have the quantity negative 1 plus 1, which is 0. A times 0 is 0, so we just have b times the quantity negative 1 plus 3, which would be 2b. So now we'll divide both sides by 2, so we can see that b must equal positive 2. Now we'll use x equals negative 3 to find the value of a. Well, if x is negative 3, on the left side we'd have negative 3 plus 5, that's 2, equals a times the quantity negative 3 plus 1, that's going to be a times negative 2, or negative 2a. Notice here, negative 3 plus 3 is 0, b times 0 is 0. To find the value of a, we'll divide by negative 2. Notice that a is equal to negative 1. Notice now we know the two fractions here on the right, where if we sum them, we'll end up with the original rational expression. So we found that the quantity x plus 5 divided by x squared plus 4x plus 3 is equal to, well, notice that a is negative 1 and b is positive 2. So I'm going to put the positive fraction first. So we'll have 2 divided by the quantity x plus 1. And then instead of writing plus and then a negative, we'll just write minus 1 divided by the quantity x plus 3. So this right side is the partial fraction decomposition of the left side. In the next video, we'll take a look at an example where we have repeated linear factors in our denominator. I hope you found this helpful.